Hello friends, today in this video training, I'll be showing you the step-by-step instructions to create a Google Map API key. Well, if you would like to professionally display Google Map section on your website, you should have a Google Map API key. If you have that key, you can display whether you have a WordPress-based website or any CMS-based website. Even you can display if you have any raw-coded website. So, don't worry, it's a super easy task, and I believe if you watch this full video, you will be able to create a Google Map API key very easily. Let's get to be started. First of all, here you can see our address, and I'll provide this link in the video description. So just click on that link. Once you click on that link, you will be sent to here. Well, friends, do not forget to sign into your Google accounts. Here you can see I have signed in. Well, here is the Google Cloud Platform dashboard. And from here, you will have to create a Google Map API key. Okay, the first job is to create a project. Say, for example, if you do anything, that should be a project, and the project should have a name. If you click on here, you will see this interface. And on the right, here you can see new project. We will have to start with creating a project. The first task is to create a project. Okay, then click on this button, new project. And you will be sent here. Okay, and here is the default name of the project, my project dash, and I'm gonna rename it to WPTARS. Okay, 01. And I'm gonna create this button, create. Sorry, just click on the button. And here you can see the project has been created. Now, if you click on here, you can see our project is listed up here. So, just click on it to select the project because we will work on this project. And the next step is to just navigate to here. You can see navigation menu. Then here you can see APIs and services. Okay, I believe you can see this. And from here, you will just go to library. Okay, already we have created a project and we are going to access the library. Okay, from the library, we will have to enable some APIs related to Google Maps. Here you can see all the maps related to Google services, but we don't need all of this. What we'll do, we'll just work with the Google Maps. Okay, just here you can see 17 APIs, but we don't need all of this because here you can see Maps SDK for Android. We are not going to integrate Google Map API key for Google Android app or something else, not for iOS app. So we'll just apply it for website. Okay, so just click on it to view all apps. And here I'll provide a screenshot or list of all the maps we will need. We will need basically 5 APIs. Just first of all, here it is. First of all, here it is. Maps, JavaScript API. Then we will need direction API. Here it is. And then we will need geolocation API. Here it is. And then we will need geocoding API. Where is that? Geocoding. Here it is. Okay. So friends, then start with Maps, JavaScript API, and I'm gonna open it in a new tab. Pretty simple task. What we will have to do, just click on this button to enable it. Okay. Okay, the Google Maps JavaScript API keys, JavaScript API is enabled. Now, get back to Place API. Okay, here it is, Place API. Just open it in a new tab. Enable it. Okay, let it work. We are going to navigate to another one, Direction API. Just hit enable now. Okay, again, we are gonna, what we have done, direction API, JavaScript API, place API. Now, geolocation API. Open it in a new tab. Enable it. And friends, we have the last one. Here it is. Geocoding API. Okay. So, let me show you again. We are almost done. Here it is. 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 Okay. Then, firstly, we created our project. Then, we enabled the APIs. Now, in the third step, we are going to access the API key, APIs and services, and credential here. Okay, now here you can see a plus sign and create credential. Just click on it, and here you can see API key. Just click on it, and it's creating API key. And here is the API key. Okay, so it's super easy. Now you can close it or you can restrict the key. Okay, but I strongly recommend you to restrict the key, because then nobody can use your API key. It will be just secure. Okay, then I'm going to click on restrict key. And here you can see some of restrictions. We are going to choose HTTP referrers because we are going to use it for websites. And here you can see website restriction, and click on add an item. And now you will have to put your domain name here. Say, for example, I'm gonna click for wp-tars.io or me domain, and click done and hit save. Okay, here you can see the green button, and here is the API key. Now only the website I have combined with this API key can access this service. That's fine. Well, friends, if you would like to professionally use this, then you will have to enable the billing option of Google Map. But now it's ready. The API key is ready. Here is the API key. Just click on it and you can use it. Okay. So where can you use it? Just if you use any WordPress plugin, you can use it. You can use to any other CMS. So that's all. I think we could easily create an API key. Well, that's all. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you in the next video. And don't forget to like this video, share this video, and leave your comment and leave your opinion. I would like to see that. And subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you.